Good morning, dear students. I'm your English teacher in Vittal Matriculation School. Today, Friday. Hey, students, hope you're all doing well, right? Had your breakfast? You have to eat vegetables, fruits. Okay, students, don't skip the vegetables. So, let's start our class. Term 2, Unit 1, Affection. And the first lesson name is Appa. Already we have seen, right? Hope you all understood this lesson. Okay, let me recall this lesson. Students, all of you listen carefully. This lesson about a girl, Meena, who was victimized by tsunami, right? Then, it is given in the form of flashback. Finally, we find that, right? It is the flashback story. She narrates the tragic experience. Here, tragic means very sad story. And she underwent during the tsunami and how she was brought up in the rehabilitation center. The concern and the unending love of the official in the rehabilitation center is also explained here. And he behaved in such a way that the children lovingly called him Appa. It is really saddening to note that thousands of children left with their parents like Meena. Yes, in the society, thousands of children left with their parents like Meena due to this massive wave tsunami. Okay, students, hope you all understood this lesson. Okay, today we are going to see about the book bag exercise of this lessons. All of you take your classwork note and pencil or pen. You have to mark the book first and then you have to write it in your classwork note. Okay, first glossary. Reside. Reside means go or move back. And then massive. Massive means large or heavy. Whirl. Whirl means to move rapidly. Rapidly means fast, right? F-A-S-T, fast. Round and round. To move rapidly round and round. That means whirl. Bank. Bank means bang. Bang means to strike forcefully and noisily. Faint. Faint means to lose unconscious. Rehabilitation. Rehabilitation means the action of restoring someone after a damage. Blankly. Blankly means without expression. Then let's see the fill in the blanks. First one, Meena's village was hit by waves on Sunday, right? Meena's village was hit by the waves on a Sunday, right? Sunday in December month. Meena was transferred to a rehabilitation center. Attacked by tsunami, Meena were transferred to a rehabilitation center, right? Center. Rehabilitation center. The official's family visited the rehabilitation center for 5 years. Yearly once, right? 5 years. FIVE, 5. The official and his wife liked Meena. The official and his wife liked Meena. MEENA, Meena. Meena studied in 12th standard. Meena studied in 12th standard. And then true or false. Read the statements and write true or false. Meena's father was a fisherman. Yes, Meena's father was a fisherman, right? So this statement is true. So you have to write TRUE, true. People ran off when the seawater receded. No, they were excitedly seeing the receded seawater, right? So this statement is false. FALSE, false. 3 waves hit the village. No, there are 2 waves. First one and second, another massive wave, right? So this statement also false. FALSE, false. Students, you have to write, okay? Write it in your book, students. I will check. The official visited the rehabilitation center daily. No, the official visited the rehabilitation center yearly once at 5 years, right? So not daily. So this statement also false. FALSE, false. The official was transferred. Yes, the official was transferred. The statement's true. TRUE, true. And then answer the following questions. What is the first question? Where is Keeraikuppam located? Where is Keeraikuppam located? Students, you have to write it, these 5 questions, in your classwork note. Okay? English classwork note. CW note, you have it, right? Classwork note. So you have to write these 5 questions only in your note. This is your homework. This is your homework. You have to write these 5 questions in your classwork note. First question answer, where is Keeraikuppam located? Keeraikuppam is a small village located near the coast of Nahapattinam. You have to write this answer in your classwork note. Keeraikuppam is a small village located near the coast of Nahapattinam. Coast of Nahapattinam. So you have to write it in your classwork note with question and answer. Okay, students, don't skip the question. You have to write the lesson name Appa, and then you have to write C dot, answer the following questions, and then put number 1, and you have to write the question, where is Keeraikuppam located, and then you have to write the answer this question. Keeraikuppam is a small village located near the coast of Nahapattinam, and then you have to put a 2 line. And then second question, put number 2, what were the people excited about? What were the people excited about? The people excited about what? This question, okay? The people were excited to see the racing waves. The people were excited to see the racing waves. Racing waves. The people were, W-E-R-E, were excited, T-O-2, S-E-E-C, T-H-E-D, racing, R A I S-I-N-G, rising waves. W-A-V-E-S, waves. And the third question, which disaster had hit the village? The disaster that had hit the village was tsunami, T-S-U-N-A-M-I. And fourth question is, who showed love and care to the children? The official of the rehabilitation center. Who showed love and care to the children? The official of the rehabilitation center showed love and care to the children. Okay, students, this is the answer. The official of the rehabilitation center showed love and care of the children. Okay. And fifth question, why did Meena call the official Appa? Do you think we need to be a family to care for others? First, why did Meena call the official Appa? Because he was loving and caring. Second question is, do you think we need to be a family to care for others? The answer is, no, I do not think we need to be a family to care for others. Students, this is your homework. You have to write the lesson name, answer the following questions. You have to put the numbers. Question with answers you have to write, okay? After you write, you have to take a photocopy of your note, classwork note, send me through the WhatsApp. Okay, students, thank you. Keep safe at your home.